Favorite people, the legendary Ox Baker, and today we're going to solve an age-old question. Can Ox Baker really solve the Rubik's Cube? It's been talked about for years and years. I don't know that it's ever been captured on video. Here is a Rubik's Cube, if you don't remember. Very popular 1970s, 1980s. They're still around today. I can tell you that this has not been done. I'm spinning it right now, and Ox Baker claims he can solve this Rubik's Cube. True or false, Ox? You can solve this.
Yes. What I do is I hand it to the cameraman, and he names me a color. So that's the first color I'm going to start with. Hand it to him.
There you go, cameraman.
You look at it and say the color.
Say a color.
Blue.
Blue.
Blue, okay. You said blue. Unfortunately, he didn't mix it up enough.
Let me mix it up again.
Yeah, blue was already done.
Blue's already close. Let's get this thing so mixed up.
I don't want you to...
I think there's a fake here. There we go.
Okay. Now you want the same color?
Yeah.
Okay. And what I've done is I've seen that there's two blue there. So what I do is I... And this cube is real tough. It's never been loosened up, but we turn it there, and we have six out of the nine, and look at this damn thing. Well, no, I can still do it.
Where did this come from, this ability?
This was a, when other guys were getting high, drunk, messed up, Ox Baker would sit in the car, keep his mouth shut, which is hard to believe, of course. And even as tough as this one is, within 35 to 40 seconds, 35 to 40 seconds, I looked three blue, six blue, and in less than a minute, nine blue.
That's amazing. Now, Ox, what about the rest of it here?
Well, you see... Yes, sir?
Your Ox Baker?
Jaws are dropping now, Ox.
What is?
Jaws are dropping.
I don't want to
interrupt. No. Stay right there. We're solving a Rubik's Cube.
And what you have to do in the cube to get to the second row, you got to have the colors coordinated. Look at there, see? You have made this extremely tough.
And the audience is growing for you. The pressure's on.
I love the audience.
I'm going to look in the office.
Okay. Was that orange or red? Must be red.
I think it's more, kind of a reddish. I would think this would be very tough. I can't even get halfway.
Well, you have to work at it for hours. If you, there's no color in place. When there's not one in place, you have to, okay. And still in less than a minute, See? Still in less than a minute, we got the blue all done. So the next thing, to do the second row, the first row is actually done, but you have to break it up because you have to coordinate you got to coordinate all the colors around the edge. See now, the yellow's all there, the blue is still up there.
Blue's still up there, yellow coming together?
Yeah, yellow's coming together. Green and orange. In a second here, we're going to get the other blue. Here it is right here. The other blue is here. And, the other blue is here, and you got to get this other blue to where this is around here. Now we have the yellow here and the blue. Now this red one here, we got to take this out of the puzzle because the only way you can do the second row is you got to have the first row. Where's the blue at? The blue is right there. Green, you're looking for. Oh, yeah. Where's the green blue? Gotta have the green blue.
This is all very. This is deep.
Oh, yeah.
That's why they call it a Rubik's Cube.
Well, it's a giant math problem. You have to be good at math.
Were you good at math in high school, Ox?
History more than anything. Now we're down to one blue. Where I can, Now we're ready for the second row. We've got all the blue in the bottom, we've got orange, yellow, and to get these, I can tell you what I'm doing, and you still will, you might not understand.
But, I can
okay,
believe it.
If this row is all green, the second row has to be green. If this is all orange, the second row has to be orange. If this row is all yellow, the next one has to be yellow, right? And so what we do is there a green, there's a green-red. Now you put this green-red at the top here. Now here's where I can't really not look at this because it's so hard to turn.
This is where you separate the men from the boys.
And what we did is we take that green yellow and put in that corner. Now this green red is here. That's have now we're looking for a red yellow at the top. And you take that red yellow, and I can almost do it without looking now because I did it so much, but. Then we got to actually, at this move here, we got half of the second row done. We got this room. Now we're looking for a green orange. Here's a green orange right here. And again, like a lot of guys got to look at it because you can't do it without looking at it, but I don't look at it. Now, what we do is we just move here and we have 3/4 of the second row done. Now the last one is left is yellow orange. We look for the yellow orange, that's up here. Now, again, without looking, I mean, a lot of guys can look and do something, but how can you do this puzzle, which is almost impossible to do, and with this move here, we have not only the first row done, but we have the second row done. The first two rows are done. And now, unfortunately, what do we got here?
We come to a stumper?
No.
No, we...
It stumped the ox, come on.
Yeah, no, what was I thinking? I was foolish.
To this orange belongs here and that orange belongs there. And,
we might need to get a throat lozenge, Ox, before this is done tonight.
If this thing had been where it wasn't super tight, where's the orange at? Oh, there it is right there. Okay, this side is done, that side is done. Orange, yellow. Okay, red belongs over here. No, red belongs there. Okay, we're moving right along, of course. What is the combination here? You gotta keep looking for the combination all the time. Where is the combination? Red, yellow, yellow, orange, orange, green. We gotta do a fancy move here, which took me months to learn this move.
How many hours a day did you work on this, Ox?
I used to work 6 hours a day.
6 hours a day? My goodness. Now, how much time did you spend in the gym in those days?
6 hours.
6 hours? So you slept for...
Well, I... Okay. Oh, there it is, right there. Okay. Now we're down to actually three moves.
Three moves, folks.
Wow.
This is getting, I know, ooh. This is something I've never seen one of these solve. This is amazing.
Wait till I show you what the last move is.
I tell you, if this is solved, I'm going to put this in a glass case in the living room. The Rubik's Cube Ox Baker solved.
Yellow.
Smashed in between two pieces of French toast.
Two moves became three moves. Three moves became four moves, by the way.
Three moves? We're going to go.
Okay.
We're down now.
Okay.
This is like two moves.
Now we are, we're at the top row. We're at the top row. We're at the top row. I keep saying that.
This is kind of like that old Mr. Wizard show.
Yeah. You see, with it being tight like that there, I can't. I can't concentrate on what the. Being tight, I can't concentrate on what the move is. I can do it almost by touch and feel.
We're back to Heather Feather, touch and feel. I think this would be frustrating, Ox, 6 hours a day.
But you, what you never did was let yourself get frustrated at it. The frustration is just, it's only because this thing is super duper tough. Where is that? because red, green, orange, green, orange, green is there. Because we made a mistake. Because we made a mistake, we gotta go all the way back. And it's only because this damn thing is so hard to turn. No, I don't think I'd have had the patience if I had this particular cube.
This will wear on you.
Red, yellow. Red, green. See, I had it down to two moves before, but because of the tightness, I got off a fraction of the puzzle. And what you never did, you see, the right there, I know I'm... Right there, I got to do three moves instead of two to get this done.
This would take deep thought.
We see this red yellow is here, but it belongs the opposite way. So what you have to do is
it's a conundrum.
I wish I could have got down to the last move, which I will. Okay, now the red yellow will be at the top. And again, we already did it, but we're doing it a second time. The second time we have the first two rows done again. And wait a second, did we get a break? We got a break. Oh, did we? No. Is that red or orange? We didn't get a break. I thought we got a break. We didn't get a break. And this is the frustration part about it, because I know the move. If the puzzle was working the way it should have, I could really go zip, bam, boom. But I can't go zip, bam, boom, because I got to keep the two rows together. There's a red, red, green, yellow, orange. See? This piece belongs over here, and that piece belongs over there. See? Right now I'm guessing because I'm fighting so hard. Here's the two orange. Here's the two orange. Where is it? Just a second.
I think the Rubik's Cube was invented by Ray Rubiks. Just a little factoid there.
Not play on words, I know.
I know.
Okay, red. Red's on the other side, and right away I know I'm screwed.
Oh, Lord. We've ran into trouble.
Yeah. See what it is, the two red, this red belongs over here, and that red belongs there. This orange belongs here, and that orange belongs there. Now, if the cube was working, I could zip, bam, boom, and get it very... Okay. That's a wondrous thing. Sometimes you can get this move here, you can go 20 minutes before it to come out right. Is it too orange or is it too orange? The two orange, the two red. That red's the right place. That red's in the right place.
We may be getting close here, folks.
What is that color supposed to be? I don't know. Is that supposed to be orange? Oh, wait.
Yeah. If you don't really, I'm doing the same move over and over and over, hoping it'll fall in the, you son of a buck. Hoping it'll fall in the place. Red, green, red. Green, green, red. See how tight that is?
Hey, how do you loosen them up?
I don't really know that. I really don't know how you loosen. Red, green, red, green. Ah, we fell into it.
Yeah. We fell into it, oh boy.
Yeah. We fell into it. Okay, wait, we'll do the next move first, and then the last move last.
I usually try to keep the last move last myself. It's a good finisher.
That one belongs over there. See, I straightened out one side, but it turns, it messes up the second side. We're down to one move, but I can't get that one move in until I get these right. And you see, every time I do it, I'm gonna try it this way then. There's a two orange. There's two orange. Where's the orange? Orange is over here. See that red thread? That red. Yellow one. See, this one belongs over there. We're down to one move, but I can't get this to cooperate with me. And do you think I'm doing the same move over and over? I am. No, I am. I'm doing the same move over and over. Trying to make them, this should fall, this might fall into place. Ah. Whew. Believe it or not. That's why this takes so much patience.
Certainly would, I...
Oh, yeah. And, myself... Okay. Myself, I never get tired of it.
It's a love.
Yeah, okay. We should be down to three moves. We'll see.
The final three.
Two moves.
Two.
But this, how many for two? What it takes for just two?
Certainly is developing.
Okay. Now.
All right.
We're down to one move on the board.
One move.
Yeah.
That's very important. One move, folks. Take a swig off the beverage. One move.
Now, I want to show you that one, how that one move is.
Here we go.
It's one... Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24.
You have got to be kidding.
Oh.
This Rubik's Cube is solved. Look at that. Folks, that is amazing. By Mr. Fantastic, Oxbaker, the solved Rubik's Cube.
Have that signed.
You see how hard it is, like that last move?
We'll keep it that way. That's pretty cool.